Hey everyone, Sam Dunn here again for Overkill Reviews to talk about a record that's probably not the most expected record we'd be talking about on this day in the metal world, but it's an album I'm pretty excited about. Check it out. That is the sound of the sophomore album from Sweden's The Lurking Fear called Death, Madness, Horror, Decay. Sounds like a bit of a biography of the state of the world right now, to be honest. Let's get into the backstory on this band. Okay, what do we know about The Lurking Fear? Well, not much information out there to dig up on this band. The Lurking Fear, of course, the title of an H.P. Lovecraft short horror book from back in the 1920s, and of course, the band is led by Thomas Lindberg of At the Gates fame and being in other bands as well. The band also features members from Disfear, obviously, God Macabre, Skid System, Tormented, and The Haunted. This band put out an EP and their first full-length, both in 2017, the full-length called Out of the Voiceless Grave. Gotta be honest, kind of went past me, didn't really register for me. This one, however, is registering. So yeah, let's get into the sound and the songs on this new one. All right, first thing to note about this, of course, Lindberg dipping back in to the stories of Lovecraft and other horror slash philosophers from decades past, which we all know is provided fodder for not just The Lurking Fear, but bands like Metallica with Call of Cthulhu. And, you know, for me, always been really intrigued by what Lindberg brings to the lyrical game of whatever band he happens to be singing for. Second thing to mention is the sound. Many of you know, big fan of that old school Swedish-inspired death metal sound that came out of Sunlight Studios way back in the old days of death metal. It's got that super dense, super almost crumbling guitar tone. It really feels like the guitars on this record are sort of just completely decimating everything around, including the vocals, which are set fairly far back in the mix, as well as the drums. But it provides that classic buzzsaw sound that really they ratcheted up on this record as compared to the last one. And then there's the songs, the advanced video tracks on the album, Cosmic Macabre and Death Reborn. Definitely enough to get me intrigued. As the black stars what I love about this record is it really seems to hit its sweet spot right around the middle with the title track, Death, Madness, Horror, Decay, and Architects of Madness. It really feels like the riffing, the songwriting, the production on this record is far more cohesive than on the previous record. There's a lot more strong ideas in terms of the way the songs are getting put together. And Lindberg even mentioned in some of the interviews leading up to the release that he said it felt like the ugly stepchild of the latest At the Gates record, which feels like the right kind of description for this new record. And the real gem in this is later in the album, the track Kaleidoscopic Mutations features a guest appearance by the one, the only Chris Reifert. It was always Reifert for me when I was a teenager. Of course, X Autopsy and one of the original super lowdown guttural vocals from the original heyday of death metal. It's just this like minute 30 plus just kind of abstract tune where Christus basically belches over the music, but a nice little touch late into the record. Frankly, not much more to say. If you like your meat and potatoes death metal and you like that old school Sunlight sound, this is a choice album. You will love this record right from those opening horror screams of Abysmal Slime right to the end with a couple of nice little cover bonus tracks nestled right at the end of the album to please the old schoolers in the room. So there you go. To be honest, I like the record and I gotta search a little bit to find something negative about it. I guess what I would say is the tune Architects of Madness right in the middle where they do halftime, it's a bit more melodic, it's a bit, you know, out of the box. I would have liked to hear a bit more of that approach on this album. So while, you know, I'm always partial to just like the straight for the jugular death metal thing, there could have been room for a bit more expansion, maybe some interludes, maybe some different ideas brought in throughout the record. But hey, you know what? I'm nitpicking. I don't want to nitpick. Let's do the verdict. This is a solid death metal record coming from some really experienced, seasoned Swedish death metal veterans. 4 out of 5 on Overkill Reviews. But before we go, we gotta do some shout-outs to some records that actually are bigger records coming out today in the metal universe. Firstly, most obviously, Exodus's new album, Persona Non Grata, out today on Nuclear Blast, Gary Holt, and Hunting. Hunting, my man, back in full force, post-cancer recovery, well done. Putting out a brand new album today as well. Germany's Obscura, A Valediction, also a Nuclear Blast, and a trio of Nuclear Blast, just owning it. We've got Chemist with Deceiver, also out today. Thanks for joining me, that was fun. And the next time you see me, I'll be talking about the best albums of 2021. But until then, go get your dose of The Lurking Fear and other great albums out today in our beloved metal world. We'll see you next time. Every morning.